Welcome to another video about drawing medieval. This is iSimulate from Foxly. If this is your first time watching my channel, I explore different simulation games and share gameplay videos of those I like. Subscribe to my channel if you're also a simulation game lover. In this game, a season lasts for 12 days. We are now enjoying the spring days. To prepare for summer, we need to build an underground storage, where temperature is relatively low and food can stay fresh longer despite the heat. It's interesting the game only tells you this when summer starts. I find it too late. It's something we should already start in spring. Taking advantage of the hillside landscape again, you can easily dig a tunnel and then a cave into the hill. By the end of spring, we manage to have an area of 4x5 squares dedicated to storing food. The temperature is 4 degrees, something like a fridge. We will expand it during summer. Maybe next year we can dig deeper. The deeper we go, the cooler it gets. On the other hand, we make good progress with research and unlock agriculture. Let's allocate this part of our settlement to growing crops. It is important to have our own steady source of food supply. After that, we only need to do hunting to get some meat. Not everyone is vegetarian. As food is so important, we unlock food preservation. After Walt reaches culinary level 10, he can make smoked meat. Already, we are planning ahead for winter. The medieval world can be brutal. We should not forget raids can hit us when we are least prepared. Therefore, we have to build our defenses whenever we can. For now, we lay down traps around and along possible routes to the settlement. Later on, I plan to dig a trench around. Last time, when we had a new settler at Tepecha, she brought enemies. But there are also harmless settlers like Lee, who is not pursued by anyone. And enemies can also just show up without any new settler joining, just like this time. Some fanatics attempt to purge the faithless. We don't have our defenses ready yet, but we must take up arms. Archers are really important in raids. Good that we now have two. Lee, the new settler, is a passionate marksman. Together with Gerard, they stand guard on the top of our defense tower, taking care of the approaching enemies. After that, our melees only need to take care of another two guys. We don't need to take all enemies down to win the raid. We spare the remaining guy this time because we cannot get him. Anyway, we survive another raid. It's time we expand our underground storage. Since it's underground, it is crucial we take care not to let things collapse on us. That's why we first dig out the tunnel, set up pillars where necessary, and then strengthen the whole thing with wooden beams. After that, we are ready to dig further and clear out the remaining part of the cave. The result is a 39 squares big underground storage at a temperature of around 3 degrees. Cool! Gradually, we should improve the different rooms in the settlement. Let's start with the simple ones, temples. If we toggle the room types legend, we see bonuses we can get by building rooms in a certain way. For example, the Oak Brethren Temple. This room requires one Oak Brethren shrine and at least two Oak Brethren wall decorations. Settlers who are Oak Brethrens get positive mood modifiers in this room. Of course, we should not leave out the Restitutionists. Similarly, we can build them a room called the Church of Restitution Chapel. While all these are ongoing, a new settler knocks on our door. Taking him in will mean another raid with one fierce forest bandit, four forest bandits, and one movable trebuchet. What should we do? It's not my intention to conclude this episode with a cliffhanger. It just happens to be. Okay, I hope you enjoyed this video as well as the game. Stay tuned and enjoy going medieval. See you next time. Take care.